But we want to start with our political plays now. It's Monday. Democrat Michael John Gray and Republican Bill Vickery here joining us this morning. Guys, for the past 2 weeks, we've been talking about this infrastructure, the back and forth. Now an agreement has been reached. Michael John, we'll start with you. Do you think that this is what is needed right now?
Well, I think what is needed is exactly what Washington is doing. One side wanted this, the other side wanted that. We're going to come together and get something passed. The president understood that Democrats and Republicans weren't going to be happy if you put both bills together. We're going to get this thing passed and move forward. We need to address a lot of these issues. I've heard Bill for weeks say we'll put them in separate bills. That's what they've done up there. We'll get the infrastructure bill passed and we'll move forward on the rest.
Yeah, the hook there, though, is on Thursday when the president marched out and said, look, we're going to, we've reached a compromise here. We've got a bill on infrastructure. 2 hours later, he was asked if the infrastructure bill were to pass, but the other bill, the bill that had all the unpopular social spending programs in it that had to be bifurcated out, well, if that doesn't pass, what would you do? And he said very clearly, 2 hours after he just had the ceremony outside the east exit to the White House, he said, well, of course, I'll veto it. They're both going to pass. I won't let one go without the other. 24 hours goes by, the White House walks out and says, well, wait. What we really didn't mean to say that. Well, what happened was, for the president, who struggles to understand what day of the week it is, he revealed the big strategy, which is the House of Representatives is going to hold up the infrastructure bill until they get all of this sort of hard left social spending that they want a Christmas tree on top of it. That's exactly what the plan was. The president accidentally revealed it because he was taking live questions from reporters. It came out. That caused a great stink. Now the infrastructure bill is in real danger on the Senate side because you've got Republicans who say, hey, I was duped. I didn't know this is what I was voting for.
Michael John, I saw you shaking your head.
No. What happened was the man said it, and he walked it back, which is what they can do in Washington.
Yeah.
He understood the Republican Party wasn't happy about that. We're
going to
get the infrastructure bill passed. But to say taking care of pre-K, taking care of the elder baby boom generation are unpopular radical socialist ideas.
And to I love how you frame it.
The point is we're going to get an infrastructure bill passed. We're going to have a separate bill, which is what Republicans have been screaming about for weeks.
They're finally
getting what they want. So we've got to find another issue here. We've got to address our roads and bridges. We've got to address the other things, too. We're going to get one passed, and Democrats have an opportunity to pass the other one. Trying to create a story out of the personal
There's no trying to create the story. The man said, I will veto the bill. He said, I will veto the bill, square to a reporter from MSNBC.
So don't we want leaders? Don't we want leaders in Washington when they realize that that is the wrong stance, that it's not effective, that can back up from what they do and say, no, we need to work together and get things done? That's what we want out of Washington.
This is what I like out of President Biden. He at least revealed the big strategy at play here. Watch what happens to the infrastructure bill on the House of Representatives side. What Nancy Pelosi has already said, because she doesn't care. This was the strategy to begin with. It's just poor old Sleepy Joe. They let him out, and he had to speak to some people, and he told them the whole plan.
Okay, guys, we do have to wrap up.
Well, when you can't attack the facts, you have to go personal, and that's what's going on.
But the people are running the facts. That's the whole thing.
Okay, guys, we do have to wrap it up. We appreciate you guys discussing this bipartisan bill. It'll be interesting to see what happens with it. Guys, thanks so much for joining us for Political.